So we've been using different customer relationship management systems for years. Now, back in 2021, we started using Kajabi, not as a CRM, but as an all-encompassing business management system to host our website, to host our online courses, and to help us with marketing. But lately, Hector and I have really dove in to see if we could replace our current CRM system, our current customer relationship management system, with Kajabi.
So today we are going to give you an overview of Kajabi CRM. There are four key things that we're going to dive into, but first we have a gift. If you are building an online course because you want to serve more people and you want to make a passive revenue stream while doing so, well, this gift is for you. It's going to teach you how to develop an online course in 90 days or less and save you $10,000 or more in the process because we demystify it for you. It's linked below. Go check it out.
So we're already logged into Kajabi here, and this is what you need to do if you're looking to use Kajabi's CRM function. Mm-hmm. Everything related to the CRM is under contacts. Now there's three areas currently. Kajabi's always making updates, so this may look different when you open things, but these are the basics. We're gonna start by going under all contacts. So when we open up all contacts, it's gonna show how many people have been added to your Kajabi CRM in your entirety of using it. Now, don't confuse this as this being the same amount of people that are on your email list, because it's not. There's a certain number of contacts who have either opted out or Kajabi routinely cleans your email list to make sure that they keep a high email trust rating so that your emails actually get to your people.
Exactly, and here in all contacts, Kajabi makes it very simple, very easy for you, respective to what you have within your Kajabi ecosystem, to filter contacts to find contacts. So let's go ahead and go through a few things here. First, if we click on Manage Tags in the top right, Manage Tags, think of them as groups, if you will. You can make a group respective to an email sequence you want to send out for that certain group. For example, Johnny and I, we have a nurture campaign. So we have a tag, a group, that everybody that we want to be part of the nurture campaign, we tag them to.
Basically, if you ever sign up for any of our freebies, including our free masterclass that's linked right below this video, you go through an evergreen email sequence where once you finish that sequence, we automatically tag you with a nurture tag. What this allows us to do is our ongoing nurture emails that we send out weekly only go to people who have already experienced our evergreen sales sequence. So if you're in that sequence, you're not gonna get any other emails from us until you complete it.
That's one other thing that we wanna note about Kajabi CRM is that they make automations very, very easy, respective to who subscribed, how have they subscribed, and how do you want them to grow within your Kajabi ecosystem. So going back to all contacts, when we go back to all contacts, you will see that there's something called segments. Now this is a way to filter the, in our case, 3,000 plus contacts that we have. You will see that in addition to the tags, you can also filter them based on customers. Are they customers of certain products that we have? Subscribed, are they subscribed to our email list as a whole? Inactive, who's inactive? Who's not interacting with us and interacting with our emails or interacting what we're sending to them?
Then you can see if any of your emails are bouncing. So if there was like a fake email given to you or if we were blocked for some reason, then you can pull that data and see who is there as well. And lastly, those tags Hector was talking about, we can actually click on the tag here and it'll pull up all the data around who has that tag.
Now, in addition to segments, if you want to dial more into your specific contacts, there is a filter button that allows you to dive more into different filters. So if you click on category, there's so many different ways that you can filter your contacts. Have they completed an assessment? An assessment is a test, if you will, that you create that maybe they go through in one of your online courses.
We have multiple assessments. We also have different coupons for sales we're doing. So we just did a Black Friday deal. So if we go to coupon, we can literally pull up the Black Friday 2023, go here, coupon used, apply filters, and we can see, I think we had 7 purchases. Mm-hmm. So as you can see, here are the 7 new students that joined on Black Friday.
So this is a great transition to the second thing that we want to cover, which is, what if you want to dive even deeper into an individual contact? Where do they come from? Where do they subscribe? Have they purchased anything? If so, what have they purchased? Do they have access to one of your products? If so, what product? There's a lot of information within each individual contact. So we're gonna use our good old friend, Mr. Johnny here, to dive into his contact card, because of course, privacy is very important and we wanna make sure privacy of all of our students and contacts are protected.
So it looks like I have 2 here, and it looks like I also bought something for $5.
All right, man, keep it coming.
Not sure what that was.
Keep it coming.
No, it was definitely a test transaction. So let's open this up and tell me what's going on here, Hector.
Okay,
so this is the contact card.
So when you click on the contact card, you will see here there's a nice summary of who the contact is.
Okay, so this is like a short version of it.
Exactly, this is a short version. Again, a quick summary. But when we click on open full profile, we're gonna get all of the information. So let's go step by step, making it very easy. So first is life cycle. And as you can see here, the first thing that we see is how long has Johnny Havey been a contact of ours. Here, he's been for 4 months.
Surprising.
Only four months. We've only been doing this for 10 years. Purchases, how many purchases has he made? So if you have, let's say, 2, 3, 5, 20 different products in your Kajabi ecosystem, what purchases, what offers has Johnny purchased?
And remember, people who have already bought from you are more likely to buy from you again. So that's why this data is so interesting. And that's why we've been really looking into stopping using our other CRM. By the way, the CRM that we have used in the past is called Pipedrive. We have a video all about Kajabi versus Pipedrive. But we're really trying to figure out if we can fully move to Kajabi, because we don't have this data in Pipedrive. So when we're looking at selling our services, which is we serve second and third time course creators and building a video-based online course, when we're looking at that market, having the data of what emails they've opened, how long they've been a contact, what they've purchased, how much they've spent, can really help us figure out the likelihood of them purchasing again from us. If they've purchased and they've spent a certain amount of money, they're probably gonna purchase again from us.
Absolutely. And what Johnny just said, you get to see how they've been interacting with you. So look how cool this is. Remember, when you are selling specifically digital products as well, you're gonna have promotions. We had a Black Friday promotion. And here we can see, out of all the emails that were sent on that Black Friday sequence, which ones Johnny opened.
I hope I opened all of them.
If we go all the way back,
I gotta show my support.
We could see literally all the emails that were sent, what was open, what wasn't open, how he's interacting. Super cool. The next thing is info. Now, this is all information that we have on Johnny. When he was added, in other words, when did he join, the exact date, how much money has he generated or spent with us?
Yeah, so if someone has been added and they've stayed on our email list for a long time and they haven't unsubscribed, that is a really good sign. Because that means that since we send out 2 to 3 emails a week, even if they're not opening them, they're still interested. They're
exactly.
still plugging in. And then what I also like here is where it says sign-in count. So if we have a student of eLearning Simplified Academy or YouTube 2K Blueprint, we can see if someone is signed in a bunch, that shows us that they're really engaged. That means that they're probably more likely to purchase another product or service from us. In this case, I don't even think I have access to a course. That's why it says 1 sign-in count. So that was probably the purchase date, was that sign-in. And yeah, here's the...
the last activity, the last time that Johnny was interacting within the Kajabi portal with an e-learning partners. So the next thing is purchases, where we get to see what has Johnny bought from us. Now, something to distinguish within Kajabi, an offer and a product. How do they work? Are they the same thing? So let's give you a real example. E-learning Simplified Academy is an offer that you can buy, but it's also a product. So if you were to go to products, let's say Johnny had bought eLearning Simplified Academy, eLearning Simplified Academy would be here because it is an offer that was tied to a real product. Now, you can have offers that people can purchase, but don't have a product connected to it. So don't get confused if you're like, how did somebody purchase this offer, mm-hmm. but when I go to products, they're not there.
Exactly. And you can have multiple offers pointed at the same products.
So exactly.
You can have a Black Friday offer, technically, for eLearning Simplified Academy.
For eLearning Simplified Academy, we have a basic offer, we have a platinum exactly. offer, right? But they're connected to the same product.
And you can have multiple products in an offer too. So you can have an offer that has three courses in it and a community, or you can have two courses in a community. You can also have coaching mixed with a course. So offers are what people buy. Products are what people get access to. So you can have offers at different price points. Mm-hmm. One of our clients offers the same course at a different price point to students, to professors, to industry professionals, and depending on what country you live in, if you're in a developing nation, you get a different price point as well, but it's the same product. So it's one product, what is that, four?
Four offers. Yeah.
Four different offers.
Four different offers. And then the last thing is notes. Now, this is great, again, if there are specific notes about Johnny that we want to note about, we can write them here and we can have access to them here. So let's jump into insights.
I love data. I love graphs. This is a great snapshot of your email list versus your contacts. Mm-hmm. Now, we keep talking about email lists because what we've learned over the past decade and what we've really honed in on over the past 2 to 3 years is touch points. Nurturing your customers that you have relationships with. And this is why we are considering using Kajabi only as our CRM. Mm-hmm. Because what this allows us to do is when we're out there talking to people, and when I say we, I mean Hector is the best relationship builder that there is. So when he's out there talking to people, he has all of this data backing him up, and he has touch points backing him up. But out of the 3,300 contacts we have, we really only have 2,000 touch points. Not every one of these contacts is going to receive an email from us every week. So this is good data for Hector to know, or insert your relationship manager or salesperson, or if you're the co-founder or founder of your company, this is probably what falls on your shoulders as well. This can really tell us, well, if someone's not on our email list, so one of these 2,000 subscribers that is really keeping track of like who we are, they're following, they love our stuff, then that's data that we know that we're not going to hear from them in person. Mm-hmm. So that person might not actually be a good lead. Well, if we want to dig into that even further, Kajabi gives us a snapshot of healthy contacts versus passive, unengaged, and inactive. And they give you a definition here. So healthy is they've interacted with you in the past 90 days.
Specifically email.
Passive, it's the last 180 days. Unengaged is basically, I don't fully understand this because it says idle. So if we really look into this, so if we click here, it says they've been idle. So I think that this means that they've been active before, but they haven't been for 181 to 270 days. And then inactive is they've been idle for more than 270 days. Mm-hmm. So this is really interesting, especially we can also include our opened email data. And look, out of our almost 2,000 subscribers on our email list, 1,200 are active. So now if you are talking to people and you want to see who is really engaged with your brand, you just look here and you're like, oh, well, these 2,000 are still on the list, but it looks like almost 2/3 of them are engaged. Mm-hmm. And these passive contacts are a good place to spend your energy and time as well. So it just gives you a snapshot of some data that really shows you who is gonna be most engaged and maybe the best people to target for different offers, to sell your services to sell your courses to, whatever. But this is just a really great snapshot of how your list is doing.
Exactly, and really quickly, another thing it gives you a snapshot on is customers, right? How many customers do you have total? How many new customers do you have? What's the customer activity look like? All the green percentages showcase how much they've increased in the last 30 days. Again, incredible statistics that can really help you and your team understand who your customers are, understand who your contacts are, understand the interactivity to help you and your team make great decisions moving forward in order to keep giving to your customers and your contacts as a whole.
So currently the last thing that we have here, a part of the Kajabi CRM, is assessments. Now Kajabi has been really confused of where to put assessments over the years. It's been in different locations, but now it's currently here under contacts. So this may move. But the reason why they have it here, at least our theory, is you can create an assessment that is part of a course, or it doesn't have to be a part of a course. So as you see here, this is how you can add a new assessment. What we've done is we have three assessments in eLearning Simplified Academy. We also have two test assessments, and there's nothing of value there. But basically, what we can do is open up one of these assessments, and we can go to view results, and we can see who has done the assessment. So of this one, only one person has done the assessment. And that makes sense because this assessment is later on in our course and it's not a required assessment because they also do it in their workbook. But if we look at one of the early assessments, this is the first assessment in our course, there's actually a lot of people that have completed the assessment. Well, this is good to know because these people are taking the course very seriously. We also are collecting specific data from these assessments. So we're gonna click on Mario here. And as you can see, it pulls up the questions and his answers. So this could give us a lot of data around these people, which may be good for selling to them, but it might also be really helpful for marketing and selling in general. So that's probably the best way to use assessments in and outside your courses. So you can have a public assessment too that people can fill out like a survey.
So to overview, no pun intended, Kajabi is an incredible CRM tool that can help you in so many different ways. Yes, there are some limitations, and we have some other videos on our channel that talks about the pros and the cons and comparing it to the Pipedrive, a CRM we've used for a really long time. But that's Kajabi, that's the overview. If you're looking to build an online course because you want to serve more people and you want to create a passive revenue stream so you can start winning time back and start doing more of the things that you love, we have a gift that will teach you how to develop a successful online course in 90 days or less, save you $10,000 more in the process because we demystify it.
And if you are looking to start using Kajabi, we can actually give you a 30-day free trial instead of the 14-day free trial that you see on their website.
And if you do decide to sign up for Kajabi with our affiliate link, no extra cost to you. We just get some support at the end. It supports us, it supports this channel, and of course, we appreciate you so much.
Thank you for the likes and subscribes.